Hi, I'm Mark Beauchesne with New Hampshire Fishing Game. I'll be joining Tom Flynn of New Hampshire Fishing Game's Owlbrook Hunter Education Center in Holderness, New Hampshire. We're going to be talking about the well-equipped hunter. Hey, Tom.
Hey, Mark. How are you?
Good. How's it going, man?
Hey, welcome to Owlbrook.
Well, thank you.
So, y'all geared up and ready to go?
Oh, I hope so. So, Tom, what's our game plan today?
Well, I figured I'd invite you here today to talk a little bit about how to prepare for different styles of hunting. And I know you like to move around and walk a lot.
I gotta keep moving, yeah.
And you know me, I like to just sit in one spot and wait for the deer to come to me. So given we have two different styles of hunting, I figured we'd talk about, you know, preparation.
Excellent. Well, I'll show you what I bring along. It's real simple. So Tom, I'm out and about. I'm roaming all day long, so I have to be light. My pack, I can cinch it down nice and tight to give me good back support. This has got a rigid support right here, keep me comfortable. Hydration, I always bring water with me because I'm going to be moving around. I want to be light and comfortable. If I'm perspiring, I'm going to get cold. Within my pack, the first thing that I make sure that's in here is my first aid kit and survival kit. I'm wrapping it now with duct tape. I can reuse this if I had a hole in my boot or what have you. That's the little water bottle trick. I have a flashlight because I'm going to be out, going out in the dark and coming out in the dark. I have neoprene boots with rubber bottoms. I'm going to be walking around in swamps and things like that. The neoprene is going to keep me warm, but not too warm while I'm moving around. The key is, for me, is traction. And I like the air bob tread. These boots are very, very light. The pair alone probably weigh maybe 3 pounds, which is next to nothing on your feet. I have compass, GPS, those types of things. An extra layer, just in case it gets a little cool out there. I carry a wool hat. Inside there is another pair of gloves, or glommets. These are mittens with the thumbs exposed. Some flagon, just in case. And some snacks, an apple. And of course, my hunting license.
The first thing you'll notice is that my pack is much larger than yours. Because of the varying styles of hunting, there's a reason for that. I sit in one place all day, so I'm going to need a whole lot more clothing, especially because I'm going to get cold and I'm going to need a lot of extra layers. I have a bunch of fleece vests, a fleece jacket, and as well as all in the Hunter Orange, because we want to have Hunter Orange armor out there. It's definitely
standard equipment.
Absolutely. I also carry, you know, map and compass a little in a bag, so in case it does rain, I have my tag, I have the law book, I have my map, compass, matches, pen to fill out my tag. I have my safety survival kit here, which is actually put out by one of my Hunter Ed instructors. It's called the safety pack, and it's a great thing. It all comes in this orange pack, and it's some things that I have in here are, you know, extra matches, a waterproof match container. I have some extra rope. You never have enough rope to build a shelter if you're lost at night. Some rawhide, the same to go along with that. I carry an extra jackknife in here. Safety blanket. This is one of the most compact things that can keep you warm, and this can really save your life in a situation where you've got to spend the night in the woods. I have these great little pocket guides for survival. We give these out in our Hunter Ed packets. They're a great tool. They have a lot of information in there that can come in handy. I have some fire starting materials, some waterproof matches, and there's some stuff here that acts as tinder, where you can actually start a fire. There's a candle in here as well. Whistle, something for a signaling device. When you're lost, you definitely want people to know where you are and you want to let them know. So a whistle every so often can come in handy. A couple extra plastic garbage bags, great if it's raining out, shelter. I actually bring some dental floss. And inside this survival pack, I have a separate first aid kit, which has gauze and band-aids and things such as for minor cuts and cuts and injuries. I carry a set of rattling antlers with me. I have various deer calls, grunt calls. I have a bleat can. I have rattling antlers. And throughout the day, every half hour, hour or so, I'll use them just to create some action in the woods and hopefully attract some deer my way. And finally, my most important item is a good, comfortable seat cushion. Believe me, if you're sitting for 8 or 10 hours in one day from daylight till dark, this is probably one of your friendliest items to have because it can get pretty uncomfortable.
Saves your backside.
Oh, yes.
Should we be in the woods now? I mean, I'm ready to go.
I'm ready. I've been ready since last night packing all my stuff. And it's funny, but I spend, you know, weeks prior to getting this pack ready. I mean, it's not just an overnight thing. I mean, every day I think of something else that I might need. And, you know, being more prepared than not prepared is the best way to go. I mean, there may be stuff in my pack that I'll never use throughout the whole season, but you never know.
To the casual observer, it may seem like overkill or even underkill of what I do. But the packing and getting ready to go on the hunt is just as exciting as actually being out there. It's much fun getting stuff together.
Yep. And, you know, as throughout the years with the different hunting seasons, I use a little bit here during turkey season and such. So when it comes to deer season, I got to gather it from all these other places and put it back into my deer hunting pack. And it's just, it's an adventure. And really, in addition to everything we've talked about that's in our packs, there's an even more important thing. Is a pre-hunt plan that you want to leave back with somebody that you know so they know where you are and what time you're going to be back.
Well, that's sound advice for anybody that's going to be in New Hampshire's woods.
Absolutely.